digital humanities as a subject has been born and how it is evolving, still evolving. So this is something which is quite very basic and very at the very primary level, which we are trying to locate it. But I suppose that by now you might have come to some understanding about this new stream of thinking. You know, this is a subject, this is a teaching, this is a publishing, you know, this is a researching. So we will try to look into this as a whole subject. But before that, let me say, I would, because I have prepared this to deal in a larger 1 hour program, so then 30 minutes discussion. But still, if the 45 minutes are there, I would not be able to give you a lot many examples to qualify it, the meaning of this. But still, I would read something then, so now then try to let you know exactly what it is. Then would try to let you know why the need for this subject, digital humanities, going to do justice to the themes which we are studying in our humanities and in social sciences. Then how this would further facilitate maturation of the knowledge and as well the application of this knowledge for the benefit of scholarship at large. You see? So now when we talk about digital humanities, you know, we probably talk about that there is something where this digital humanities takes place, where it occurs, digital humanities. And it occurs at the intersection of digital techniques or computational techniques and the disciplines of humanities. There is an intersection where the disciplines of humanities and technology, you know, they are not only interface, they intersect. But there it takes place in the context. You know. So this is somewhere, you know, this makes a systematic use of resources, you know, in the humanities as well as analysis of their applications with interaction. What we call technology and computational techniques and the digital systems of digitization of our subject. So now here what we say that it involves three things. It is a collaborative, it involves many you know, stakeholders, it is interdisciplinary, and it is a computationally engaged research, teaching and publication. We can also transdisciplinary and computationally engaged research. You know, I would explain to you all this, what it ultimately comes into, with examples also. So this involves this large amount of work, you know, and it brings digital tools and techniques, you know, method for the study of humanities. And there is a two-way relationship in this. So when we are involving the tools and techniques and methods, you know, both a highly you know, modern base of pedagogy to disseminate and understand. So when we involve it, I will try to list each and every aspect which we are involving. So now, in that context, what we are doing it, we are trying to understand how these modern gadgets and computational techniques, tools and methods, they impact humanities, social sciences. It's one way. And how humanities tries to culturally impact these techniques. How they try to impact them. The main contention, they say that, you know, how we will try to look into this, how the subject, you know, and technology to humanistic questioning. And how does various subjects must be used methods, be used techniques. Then we try to make a critique of those techniques, make a critique of those, you know, gadgets, that how they would be able to help us to understand. So this is Sampier. What we want to say, that digital humanities are born at the intersection of these two spheres, technology or computation and humanities discipline. So they are taking in the shape of, you know, where collaboration is involved at different levels. How the collaboration is involved, I will come to you immediately. Then it is computationally engaged research. It's a research, but not only research like if somebody is doing in chemistry lab, only dealing with, you know, chemicals, only dealing with certain elements. No, it's not only that. So now chemical is a field and researcher is the one who doing his work or her work on chemicals, but at the same time various things involved, which are trying to make a 3D presentation of chemical, how the elements are doing, make a, you know, then a video system of making those elements available to others, audio system, somebody is working there. So somebody is working in American laboratory, somebody is working in Toronto, somebody is working in Japan, they are trying to relate it, they are going to do so many things, no? So it's not a one researcher, so many researchers are working on this. Some are working from environment angle, some are working from pollution, some are working from its effect on the genes of the human beings who are doing this research, somebody impacting how it causes cancer, somebody saying that how it make concerned with the overall cosmic things while sending some fumes into the air. So those different angles. So this is everything is being controlled. How it's done, I would quickly come to that also with certain very, very strong example. My purpose is this, that if we have come here, so something you will definitely get from this lecture, that some idea would be made. It's fascinating, very interesting, because I had exposure to these studies because I taught for a long period of time in different universities abroad, in Europe and America and in Japan. I had exposed a little bit, which may be useful in this. And I did not take much research in it because my area is a typically research on the marginals in the Punjab villages. But this digital technology, you know, are not employed while doing my research. But definitely, I know that how it works. But this helped me to understand that. So thereby I was able to touch into, to get hooked into a lot many information by doing this. You can also be benefited for that if you can apply this thinking. It's a very interesting thing. So the research which we are going to do, don't think that your research would be excellent if you apply this. If you do digital humanities, you would do an excellent work which would earn you Nobel Prize. Don't think like that. This is somewhere which can help it, no doubt. It will improve the quality of the work. But the research, the merit, the scholarship, you know, which is there, you know, at present, so would not be, you know, enhanced by this. But then why it was needed? Some phone band kar do changa hoga. So now, then in that context, how this would help it, I will come in the later leg of my lecture. It's something very interesting. So this happened at a specific point of time. Now, we are dealing with this. Now I'm trying to take your attention for 5-6 minutes, very rapt attention, to define this subject. So this is not my definition. This is a definition which are given there. So I'm going to define these subjects in that sense. So this is very much important. I would be reading within quote and unquote. You see? So one we can study, these quotations are taken from a book which is called Debates in the Digital Humanities. You know, this was published in 2016, only 4 years before. And this is second volume, Debates in Digital Humanities. You might have heard up till now, many teachers might have told you, there's a book like Debates in the Digital Humanities, 2016 publication, second volume. So you can get it online, available. You know, I will repeat, Debates in the Digital Humanities. Now what they say, you know, what they try to define, they say that they acknowledge the difficulty in defining this subject. You know, so why difficulty? Because techniques every day are born, new techniques are found, new techniques are invented. So the more the techniques are invented, you can't say the permanent, you know, definition. So then, but today is digital humanities. Day after tomorrow would be different because new technique would come. And techniques are mind-boggling. It's very interesting. But if you can master those techniques, learn those techniques, don't say you become a scholar. Those techniques are only games. So now here I would quote the example. Before that, I will read little bit. So that you will get some idea of this. I think those who are sitting in the last chairs, they are hearing me. Okay. Now here comes the meaning, the definition of this. Now when we talk about within quotes. They say that along with the digital archives, you know, the digital archives means that archives where we have a lot of data, lot of information, you know, in the digital form are kept. It's called a data archives. So we have a books, articles, we have a reports, we have, you know, different proceedings. That is archives, but not digital archives means where everything is a digit, that archives. They say that digital archives, quantitative analysis and tool building projects that once characterized the field, you know, at that time, thereby they say, what is definition for digital humanities? That digital humanities at one point of time deals with digital archives, tools, it deals with quantitative analysis, it deals with tool building projects, but now it is much more. So it now includes a wide range of methods and practices. Digital humanities include a wide range of methods and practices away. What are those? This is visualization of large image sets. Visualization of large image sets. For example, you are studying, you know, what you are studying? You are studying, say, medieval history. So in the medieval history, or you are studying certain rocks, or you are studying, you know, certain elements and matters in physics, or you are studying certain themes, logbooks in computational, you know, management things, no? Or you are studying in human psychology, the certain diagrams of mind, cognition, like that. So these are examples. So now here, what are you doing in the digital humanities? You are trying to make visualization of large images, you know, sets. So here are certain images. So make them visual. You know, then you put them on a large screen. So you got South Asia. It's a one image. So put a map of South Asia with lot of colors. No? So do put on the button. Press the button. The whole map will open up. So now then you find it that on the one side, the Afghanistan, which is not South Asia, then Sri Lanka, then Bhutan, then Myanmar, then you find Pakistan, then you find so many countries. No, to try to give them color. So visualization, so you are studying. So digital humanity is not something which is injecting something. It's already the association, you are studying it. You need to study rocks, but now they put a rocks in a 3-day basis. You study some chemicals, they try to put a chemical in other ways. So now you try to put it projection, visualization of what they say, exactly large image sets. You know, then 3D modeling of historical artifact, 3D modeling. Suppose you are reading some Peruas, they are, you know, pyramids, no? So you make a 3-day images of those pyramids, no? So try to make it, or any other subject, whatever you study, you can apply on your mind, your subject. You make a 3-day modeling of those artifacts which you are studying. So now you try to look into it, you're studying architecture, for example. Try to make a Gandhi Baba's 3-day image. You find it, okay. It looks it gives you a much more larger picture of that. So this is not going to improve your scholarship. Yes, it's going to improve. But how it will improve your overall understanding of the architecture? No? Simply showing does not make it improve it. You know? Running on a treadmill would not make you a marathon great sports person. It depends on, it's a one thing we do doing it. I'm building a little bit of critique in the better here. You know, 3D modeling, you know, 3D modeling, you're trying to trying to make it. Then you are doing born digital data. Born digital data. Have you heard the term pehle? Born digital data. Have you heard it?
No, sir.
बहुत अच्छा हो गया ये करना चाहिए था. Born digital data. Note करो. Born digital data. Born digital dissertation. Born digital information. ये क्या है? What is this born digital? One is that आपने ये लिखा. आप जो लिख रहे हैं. Now this is one. So now you try to transfer it into digits. You know, you try to put it into computer and make it share with others. But other one is that what I'm speaking, you are directly transformed to certain electronic system. You are directly putting it into some sort of a, you know, on your phone. You are directly trying to put it into your, you know, smartphone. So this is born digital data. Nowhere written. There is no file. There is no photocopy would be available. It's all in born. You are writing your dissertation directly on the screen. So it's born digital. You know. So this is something born digital. We are trying to model. So look, then we have a hashtag activism. Hashtag activism. You might have heard about the term. You know, hashtag. You know what we talk about hashtag. Activism. What is that? Because you have a Twitter system. So now there you try to do something. You make a some summary of a thing, you know. You put it into hashtag. So there would be a lot of people who are liking it, you know, giving their comments, you know. So it's activism. Hashtag activism. Whatever the research are doing, you just put it on a Twitter. So there's this again the born data. Then we can have a idea of a hashtag activism. So you're trying to do this with Twitters. So you hear the people involved, although they are from the field or not, they would be involved, they try to talk about it. Whether they are scholars in the field or not, it does not matter. Everyone would be, you know, involved into that. So they say this called hashtag activism. And the analysis of that, thereof, then to make some idea how many people liked it. You try to say that there are thousands of hits, thousands of likes, thousands of people who have commented on it. So like this. Then we have idea like, Alternate reality games. So what are these alternate reality games? It's a very interesting theme. If you can go to Google, try to put print in the Google screen, alternate, you know, reality games. You get it, what they are. There are many games. You know, I have discovered like Love Bees, Hello 2, Find 815, Lost Experiences. These are alternate reality games. What are these games? These are played in real time. But games are not real. They played in real time and they try to put those ideas, trying to, like in the comics, you know. They try to tell the students through comic what the world is, how the society is, how we come into being, how the human come into being. They try to, through in real time. For example, you might have seen the movie, you know, Sam Jada's movie.
Animated.
So that's a real time, but alternate life stories in real time. You find it how? Because they didn't choose for Sam Jada because this would be a blasphemy. Because nobody, you know, so they tried to animate it. So this is a small thing of very, very crude definition of, you know, we can say alternate reality games. So these are games that are played in your research, in your research, especially in the poetry, in the drama. In so many other texts, in the history subject, in psychology, especially in psychology, alternate games. You know, those who are doing psychology, if they do the research through digital humanities, they do this game through alternate reality games. So these are the massive alternate reality games. They are so much technical, the game on it. You try to thrash out the subject so clearly, so minutely, so meticulously, you try to go in deep into that. So you can well imagine, earlier you used to attend seminars and refresher course on, you know, orientation course on research method. Those are nothing. They are only minus one only. So now digital humanity, something has gone, it has crossed all the borders. It has crossed all the boundaries. Now here alternate research games came, alternate reality games came. There should be one lecture on alternate reality games. One lecture on one, you know, data management. There's one lecture on 3D modeling. You know, all these things. So, abhi maine iski definition puri nahi ki hai. Just going to say, what is just digital humanities. Digital humanities is not prani computation. It's not something measuring, something like that. This is not something that we used to do. This is now, this is what we are going to do it. No? So now, here we are trying to talk about mobile, you know, makerspace, mobile makerspace. Mobile makerspace. So, here we have a makerspace. These are the mobile makerspace. Where we have made some space in within that space. This is quite technical terms. There we will try to relate with each other. So, you know, get in touch with each other through groups, you know, and more. So, you know, so thereby, what is called? It's all this is called is a big tent DH. It's called all these methods putting together are called big tent DH. Big tent TENT. Big tent DH. Big tent digital humanities. So you know, I will take a little small portion of this big tent. What is was there? You know. So until unless you understand this big tent, you can well imagine this very technical subject. So now specific scholars, specific resource person should be there to talk on this. This is not something we jay ho gaya, wo ho gaya. It's very, very specific, to the point. It's very technical. It's very, very technical. If you don't know, then don't know it. So then you have to do a lot of work. You have to, even if you come to give a lecture, you need to be much more worked hard on this. Because here you're talking about method. You're not, I'm not going to speak on lectures. I'm not going to speak on, you know, social mobility. I'm not going to speak on peace. I'm not going to speak on, you know, any physics topic, nor a chemistry topic, nor a management topic. I'm speaking on something doing research in the digital age. That's the theme that we're trying to talk about. So now what is big tech digital humanities? This big tech digital humanities is 2011. A subject was called like big tech digital humanity, big tech DH. If you can go to Google, you will find it. I also put there. There are a lot of literature there existing on this. No? So they say that you know, there has been a great deal of concern recently about questions of how we should define digital humanities. No, we are defining this. So now, so in his various lecture, John, you know, Unsworth says that DHSI humanities, digital humanities, asked how we might define the boundaries of our discipline. So where we start, you know? So we find it that in a different way, scholar Tiras, she has tried to explain it in her widely reported plenary study, which is called DH 2010, Digital Humanities in 2010, warned us that we must not only understand our discipline ourselves, we should not only understand our subject ourselves. Agar maine history padhi hai, toh I should not only understand my subject history as I understand it, but be able to communicate it briefly to others. How I can make my subject, if you not, you are a scholar of chemistry, you want to communicate me to my research, how you can communicate to me? I can't understand in your terminology what is chemistry. If I want to communicate to you my research, I can't communicate with the person who are not in my field the way I understood it. So now, digital humanities will make it more transparent, more easily available to you, you know, more easily coming to you. I will talk to you. So all these methods which we are talking about, these are methods which are coming somewhere within the, under the big tent, you know, ideas of the subject. So now, this is, there we find it, now, historically, but we find that digital humanities developed, you know, out of humanities computing. Historically, bahut saal pehle nahi, few years before, it developed out of what we call humanities computing. When we start using machine, when we start using computers, when we start using certain, you know, technical ways to understand writing, you know, then disseminating information, putting into tables, putting into graphs, then making certain statistical tools to present them in different interesting tables, no? In diagrams. We started doing this research. See, 50 years before, we won't use so much tables, diagrams, maps. No, now we started using all these things. If you study that election studies, if you study something about the census, you study the economic growth, you study the demand and supply, you study the, you know, you find those chapters, those papers, those books are replete with, you know, so many diagram, beautiful diagram, you know, color diagram, color, you know, tables. You know, this was that we started doing our humanities. So this was, they say, historically, and you know, digital humanities evolved, born in humanities computing and has become associated with other field such as humanistic computing, humanistic computing. So where we try to deal with behavior, other ethics, you know, then social computing. Social computing, this is subject computing, now humanistic computing, then social computing and media studies, especially this study started with the media, you know, with the media, digital humanities, you know, like postmodernism started with architecture. So the digital humanities started with media studies. You know. So in concrete terms, now I need your attention. The digital humanities embraces a variety of topics from curating online collection of primary sources. Curating, you know the curators, in the libraries there are curators, in each library there are curators, you know, after some time curators are given the status of a lecturer also. And you see, they say that they are very good scholar. Curating, what does it mean? Curating, they say, online collection of primary sources, primary textual sources. This is a one thing which include in the digital humanities, curating courses. To the data mining of large cultural data set. The term like data mining. I told born data, not data mining. Have you heard this term before? Data mining? Yes. Yeah. So, very well, because technical people do this. This is interesting. What is data mining? You know, there's a huge data. You know, so now you're trying to get from that, like it's a sea, a huge sea. You are diving into sea, trying to find some pearls. You know? So that is sea mining. You know? So what is data mining? You are working on a theme, no? Somewhere in your social science. So now you're trying to, you have been access to data, large data. So there's a lot of data on social survey data, you know, data on population. So out of population data, what you're mining? You're mining data on how many are per family girl child. How many, you know, families are, you know, nuclear families. How many families are, you know, joint families. So mining it, you're trying to data mining. You know? So then digital humanities incorporates both digitized and born digital data. Digital means which was there in written form and you put into digital form and which was there directly created through the machine. So it also includes both, you know. And combine the methodologies from traditional humanities, subject. You know, you are doing the subject, you are taking from rhetoric, from history, from ethics, from music, from archaeology, from philosophy, from linguistic, from cultural studies. You take benefit from those studies also. You are doing your study, you are doing the economics, but you are trying to take advantage from those subjects. You know? We have a Anatole Rappaport. He was a great musician and he gave us a game theory. And this game theory came from his understanding of mathematics and his musicals. We find it. Mostly the great mathematician also used to be good musician, because there's some sort of a link with music and mathematics. You may not knowing it. You may be knowing it. You know, mathematics and music, they go by hand. So the best mathematician were, you know, musician. And the best, you know, scholars in music, they were mathematicians also. You find it very interestingly. So they try to make use of them. And, you know, social sciences. This is the humanity social sciences. So now, this is with tools, you know, provided by computing, such as hypertext. So when you are doing research, you use then humanities and social sciences, then use the tools, hypertext, hypermedia. Have you heard the word hypertext? And hypermedia also. So the hypertext, what hypertext is? Those who don't know it. You are doing something, then you come on hypertext, you know, screen. So now you are writing on, say for example, poverty. Immediately your hypertext would link you with so many things, you know, on the table. You know? the scarcity of resources, it leads with less demand, and less supply. You deal with poverty, deal with famine, deal with violence, discreet poverty. So you will text, you put one word, you are doing on poverty, immediately when you hypertext, you get suddenly, here you are putting something like poverty. So suddenly when you hypertext, you will get open so many windows on poverty. You will be surprised. Oh my God, this can be interpreted. You have it in your, in your unconscious mind, those issues which are there. So it would link you to so many things. Now you can well imagine. You are not only walking only simple poverty. You have been told that poverty cannot be understood the way you are understanding it. You can't understand this poverty like this. So now, if you try to look on poverty, then you give you data. How many people in India are living in shanty colonies? How many people in India are having two-wheelers? How many people are having luxury cars? How many people are flying more by jet? How many people are having their own private jets? So data comes. Oh my God, my God, what is it? What am I doing? I'm walking in poverty. What should I do with private jets? You will find it. But it's there. You are knowing poverty. The digital humanity kehti hai. Hum aapko batayenge poverty kya hoti hai. Hum aapko batayenge ki what the life is. I will tell you what family means. So these are the stories. Hypertext. Hypermedia. Hypermedia mein toh aur bhi hai. Aapko visual bata dega wo. Audio bata dega wo. Photo ke saath bata dega wo. Everything. You would be the way you open a screen, so you need to tell. Bandhar khul jayega information. Aap kehte hain ki mere ko PhD karni thi, data nahi milta, wahan par ye ho jayega. My God, itna data kya ho gaya? Ab lagega you will find it that somewhere you are lacking in the things. No? You would not be able to control it. Then here you are collaborating. You are not doing research. Somebody else is doing research with you. It's a collaborative research. It's a transdisciplinary research. It's a computationally engaged research. You are not really searching. Then you will find that how come one article, 100 authors? Kaise ho gaya wo one article, 100 authors? Weighted study in a controlled laboratory. They found that this has been very useful to make water purify. Much more better than a chemical. They wrote a paper. That paper was published in 42 impact factor journal. Highest impact factor. One person to publish in that journal was Professor Kesar from chemistry, and second one, this Mr. Sushil Kansal. And that girl got immediately post-doctorship in Canada. They said, please come and do PhD with us. And they said, this is your original work. You can well imagine. And how this work came? From grandmother. You tell me, how grandmother knows science? She has intermittent. So here is a mighty, what we can't say, this is a hypertext. Hypertext folklore. If you want to understand Punjab, you can't understand Punjab, those who are working in Punjab. If you want to understand, the Godar Zaheer, Varesha Zaheer. So if you understand Punjab, read Varesha, then you get Punjab, what is Punjab. Read the Godar, what is Punjab. If you want to understand what happened between the Singhs and the British soldier, then read Muhammad Tak, that is Jangnama. You try to understand it. If you want to understand what happened in the medieval time, how the people lived here, read Pulesha, read Farid, read, Maulana Baksh, you read them, only then to come to know about this. Now you tell me, if somebody says that I want to know Punjab, I come from California, I want to study Punjab, I said read here, he said what nonsense is it? They can't understand it. This is a hypertext, hypermedia. Then to produce here on the screen, bring here live on the screen. Then alternate, reality games. You make Ranja here somewhere, Banjali bja raha hai, Pasu chaad raha hai, woh turi turi isko turi khila rahi hai. Then you find that this is love. It's not a love, this is something which tells about how the women are constrained. At that time, how they can't meet it. And she has to be fooled her father to recruit him as a Majja Chandwala Ranja. But that was her lover. So now this becomes live on the screen. Mind-boggling. Mind-boggling. You are doing something, study in Punjab, you are doing reading here. Then you try to bring, who is the Nath? Who is Jogi? Why he goes to that Dera? What role of Deras were there? Why Jogis are interfering in the love? They need, why they say that to me here, they who are you? Bloody to get me here. Five people are there. They said, okay, peace, world, reward in love. You see it. You know, peers are there, the sons are involved in love. Now you say that why, you know, do try to relate to this. All this is psychology, all this is sociology, all this is social anthropology of a region. So deras were not only important today, they were much more important at that time. So deras were given thousands of acres by Akbar, by other, you know, they were given jagirs of that. What about that? So are they only saints? Are they only sadhus? Are they only sons? No, they were the one who really hold power, social power in their hand. You can't make them. You can't make them angry with you. If you make them angry, your gaddi will be gone off. So thereby, you have to keep life. You have to keep, you know, happy Nizamuddin Aulia Sahib. You have to be very much close with Sarmat. If you try to behead Sarmat, then your kingdom would be off. You know, all these things are very interesting. You find why Buddhu Shah had to come to support Guru Gobind Singh in one of the wars, in the foothills of Malaya. Why Buddhu Shah and his sons were, you know, sacrificed. Try to understand it. So these are very, very, very great things. But these things are not taught in the Indian university. We are not only, you know, much aware of this. These things are
need much more scholarship, much more. Minimum 18 hours studying, mind open, meeting those scholars. But here, ਸਾਡਾ ਤਾਂ ਮਤਲਬ ਅਨਕਾਨ ਦਾ ਪਰਪਜ਼ ਹੈ, ਨੌਕਰੀ ਮਿਲ ਗਈ ਜਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਸੋਸ਼ਲ ਦਾ, ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨੋਟ ਕੰਸਰਨਡ ਵਿਦ ਨੌਲੇਜ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਯੂ ਮਸਟ ਬੀ ਬਿਟਨ ਬਾਈ ਅ ਬੱਗ ਆਫ ਨੌਲੇਜ. ਆਪਕੋ ਕੀੜਾ ਕੱਟਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਏ, ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਨਾ ਬੀ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਬੋਨੇਟ, ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਮਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਆ ਗਿਆ, ਘੁੰਮਣੀ ਚਾਹੀਏ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਟੱਡੀ ਹੋ ਜਾਏਗੀ, ਦੈਨ ਟੂ ਫਾਈਂਡ ਮੈਨੀ ਥਿੰਗਸ ਆਰ ਦੇਅਰ ਵਿਚ ਆਰ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ. ਸੋ ਲੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਹਾਈਪਰ ਮੀਡੀਆ. ਨੋ ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਟੋਲਡ ਯੂ ਡਾਟਾ ਵਿਜ਼ੂਲਾਈਜੇਸ਼ਨ ਇਨ ਫਾਰਮਲ In information retrieval, there are certain ways to retrieve the information. You know, text mining. I told you like data mining. No, text mining, digital mapping, and digital publishing. All these subjects are there. Then apart from this, digital humanities also deals with other aspects also. Those are very much important. What are those aspects? Those are related field of digital humanities. Are like software studies. You know, software studies. Have you heard about software studies? Anybody? Software studies?
Yes, sir.
What does software study mean?
Studies, whenever a software is created, that is being analyzed by the people, that what are their requirements, or unke hisab se jab hum usme updations lekar aate hain aur unko improve karte hain. Like you take the example of Microsoft Word. Jab Word bana tha, to wo as a typing software bana tha, but by the time when people realized ki unko grammar bhi usme chahiye, usko synonyms bhi chahiye, antonyms bhi
chahiye. But this is only one hardware effect of the software. But this much more. They say that this deals with, this is emerging. Software studies is an emerging interdisciplinary research field. So BIT studies software, not software, BIT studies software system and their social and cultural effects. Ultimately, what do you think? Software bana diya apne, apne kya bataya? Software studies, ultimately, software studies is a new subject in interdisciplinary field in which we try to study software system as such. And how they are socially and culturally affecting the society. That is one, no? So the implementation and use of software has been studied in recent fields such as cyber culture, internet studies, new media studies, digital culture. That prior to software studies, you know, software was rarely ever addressed as a distinct subject of study. Before we have a software study, software has ever been subjected to such studies. No? Software studies is an interdisciplinary field to study software as an artifact. It draws upon methods and theories from the digital humanities and from computational perspective on software. Software studies draw information from digital technologies, from software technology, then make a new subject. It's a long, if I start reading, 45 minute mein toh 30 minute de chahiye mere ko. The software studies, no? That we said platform studies. Have you heard about the term platform studies? Platform studies, no? This is again very, very interesting, no? So platform studies, this is a new field, I'm telling you. So platform studies is a book series published by the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT Press. You know, that invites authors to investigate the relationship between the hardware and software design of computing system and the creative works produced on those systems. Platforms have been around for decades, but they were not studied digital abilities. Right from our video games and digital art, platform studies. You can go, please, all the study must read something. Whether you are interested in this coursework or not, for their own sake, for their own growth, for their own up to date, please read what the platform studies, what is software studies, what is text, what is hashtag activism, what is, you know, all the terms which I'm telling you, one, you know, digital, please read them. At least thoda sa aware ho, aapka bachcha hi kal ko aapko puch sakta hai ki mamma ji batao mere ko ye kya hota hai, main kya bolunga, because they are going to have this. Must be aware, chahe wo aap science ke hain, chahe social science ke hain, chahe aap kisi ke, papa ko bhi to puch sakta hai, mamma ko nahi puchna, par papa se aksar puchte nahi hai, papa se darte hain, wo kisko bata de nahi hai, nahi puchte hain.